In this video, using all of the methods we've learned so far, let's go in and get into finalizing the body, fins, and legs for the character. First, we need to get the general shape for the neck as well as the rest of the body. So, similarly to the eye stems on the head, we could go in and create a mask for this area and quickly pull this down. I'll press and hold Control and paint in a small mask under the head. Inverse the mask. Now we can use the Move brush with a large draw size and pull this entire area down. We can start to smooth the transition of this area. If we turn on Polyframe, we have once again stretched the mesh, as you can see, which doesn't have enough resolution to move and sculpt this area. Let's re-dynamesh the surface by pressing Control, dragging our cursor on the canvas, and letting go of our mouse or pen. Now, with this surface nice and clean again, we can go in and smooth out these areas and continue to create the shape for the body of the character. Dynamesh makes all of this possible by allowing us to remesh as we need to and continue to add and make large adjustments from the base mesh of the character. Now let's get some fins in here for the arms. So I'll add two fins on the side and of course the standard shark fin on his back. Going in with the masking brush and drawing a mask on the sides of the body as well as the back. Now switching again to the move brush, and I'm going to start to pull out the arm fins. And also pull out the larger fin on the back. And now clearing the mask, I can go in and reshape these a bit further with the move brush and smooth out the transitions of those surfaces. I'll re-dynamesh the surface to add more resolution for clean sculpting in these areas. For the front fins, I want to give a little thumb-like adjustment here at the bottom, so I'm scaling closer to the mesh and adjusting my draw size smaller to pull this area down. For the large fin on the back, just using the move brush from different angles to pull these areas out to get the tapering of the fin the way that I like and smoothing the transitions as I go. Lastly, I need to give him some legs. Using the masking brush, just quickly paint in two circles at the base of the body and making sure that these masks don't cross, as I want to keep space between the legs. Now inversing the mask and switching again to the move brush to pull down the legs. Instead of adding toes, I want to make the feet sit flat on the ground for more of a stylized look. Flattening the bottoms here can be a bit tedious when using the core sculpting brushes that we've been working with, so I'd like to use a different brush called the H Polish brush. The H Polish brush reacts to the surface as a flattening tool. Rotating to the bottom view of the foot, I can make a larger draw size and flatten the entire foot, and continue to rotate around while using the move brush to reshape these flattened areas. With our final major shapes added to the character, I'm going to continue to refine and shape around these areas with just using my core sculpting brushes, and start to work towards the final neutral stance for the character before moving on to the final detailing phase of the sculpt. That should do it for all of the appendages of my character. In the next part of this series, we'll be focusing on finalizing the mouth and teeth of the character, as well as adding some final posing adjustments. Thanks for visiting Z Classroom, and I'll see you in the next video.